Okay, so tip number one, before the day of the interview, in case if you don't have the Zoom app or any other tool that the employer is looking for, have that downloaded on your laptop or a computer, number one. Number two, navigate yourself through this tool so that you are comfortable using it and you're not struggling on the day of the interview. So to avoid the nervousness and, you know, you remain calm and not get stressed. We don't want you to get stressed on the day of the interview.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, have enough backup specifically towards your internet connection. I've quite often seen that most of the candidates have only one connection, you know, that is common Wi-Fi or a hotspot. Please also have other modes, like have a dongle or have a LAN connection, have a Wi-Fi and a hotspot. So in case if you see an alarm on your laptop during the conversation, your network is getting unstable, you can immediately switch and not create a distraction or, you know, get dropped from the interview or your voice is cracking, for example. So to avoid and have an amazing experience there, right? Number three, have well in advance the meeting connection link and the password from the employer. Most often they will do send this to you, but in case if they haven't, you may want to give a reminder and let them know that you don't have it and have that links available with you. Most of the employers also do a testing before the interview. If that happens, that's fantastic. You know, that will help you get more comfortable with the tool and the technology. Okay, mm-hmm. That is one. Second, okay. On the day of the interview, you know, find a quiet place which is not where you're not facing a lot of distraction, right? Have a quiet place where you can lock yourself and give the interview peacefully.
Okay.
You don't want the family members passing by, you know, talking on the phone and you're giving the interview. So interviewer might get distracted, one. And second, he might feel you're not professional. Because everything they're going to observe, they might not tell you all the time, but yes, they will observe all of these things. Then always have a pen and a paper and a glass of water next to you. Just in case if you're overwhelmed, you're stressed, you're dehydrated, or you want to have a glass of water, you need not get up from the place. You can just have a glass of water immediately and then you can calm yourself down.
Mm-hmm.
Have a pen and paper. You never know if the interviewer tells you, why don't you solve a problem for me? Then you don't want to go searching around the house, where is my paper, where is my book, or, you know, pen and all of that. So have all of this handy. Then comes on your dress code. Now, dress code is something a lot of us get a little confused. What is formal? What is business casual? Right? Business casual is a complete no when it comes to interview. Formals is what I will highly recommend, and the reason being is the most safest thing you can do. You can never go wrong in formals. The formal colors, for example, blue, beige, white, light pastel colors, olive color, brown color. You could pick those, you know, when you're wearing your formal clothes. Number one.
Mm-hmm.
I've also experienced, you know, a very funny situation, in fact. For some reason, you have to get up. And you're not formally dressed. I understand the screen only the top part is seen and not the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
But I highly recommend you to dress from top to bottom. What if, you know, for some reason you might have to get up? And then you don't want to offend the interviewer, or he sees something which he's not supposed to see. Maybe in shorts or, you know, whatever that you're wearing, pajamas or night suit or whatever. So highly recommend dress fully from top to bottom. One, that being the reason. Second, dress, the kind of dress that you wear, you know, the formal attire, that kind of brings psychologically confidence in you. You know, it keeps you alert. You know, try doing this exercise, you know, whenever you're free. Try working when you're in pajamas and try working when you're wearing formals. You will see the difference in your psychology itself. And that is why I highly recommend, you know, when you get into interview, dress from top to bottom, right?
Mm-hmm.
That is another one tip which I feel is extremely important. Then work on your body language. Not many of us understand. We communicate a lot through our body. It never happens that we don't talk. We always talk. You know, my body is always constantly talking, even if I'm not using verbal conversation or verbal words, right?
Mm-hmm.
So don't keep playing with your fingers, you know, like, you know, breaking your fingers or clenching your jaws, because the interviewer is observing everything, even the blink of your eye. You know, how many times are you blinking? You know, are you nervous? Are you playing with your face, you know, wiping your sweat, playing with your hair? You don't know what you're doing because you're so nervous. Mm-hmm. And these things happen most often unconsciously. So work on your body language when it comes to video interview or it's face-to-face interview. Okay, 55% communication is done through our body. So you can understand how important it is. Then comes on your other etiquettes, like always be on mute. Especially, for example, if your apartment is towards the roadside. Now you cannot control the noise what's happening on the road, right? Yeah. So you may want to tell the interviewer, there's little background noise because I stay facing the road. So I will be on mute when I'm not talking so that you are not distracted. Let the interviewer know. Just don't go on mute directly and the interviewer will wonder, why are you going on mute? Right? So yeah. Let him know, let her know why you're going on mute in case if you want to. Off all your notifications. For example, if you're giving interview during your office hours, you may want to off the notification which comes on your Outlook inbox. The mails keep popping up, right? And you don't want to get distracted. So disconnect the notifications. Disconnect the notifications on your mobile. I highly recommend don't keep on vibration. Keep on silent mode. And also, assuming if this is your phone, don't keep the phone the screen facing towards you. Instead, keep the back facing towards you so that you are not distracted if the phone rings or if you get a message. Your focus is not going otherwise, right? That is extremely important because I have experienced myself when I was taking interviews, you know, candidates do get distracted. Any distraction is not great, especially when you're giving interviews. Why? Because you might miss any other important conversation the interviewer is trying to have with you. That is one. Other important part is choose a professional background, like the one you see behind me. It's a clean wall, or you can have a plain wall, or maybe you can have a painting or something that way, but not a cluttered one. Why? Because it might distract. It kind of shows as if, you know, you're unorganized. You know, however you stay in the house, it shows your personality at the end of the day, right? Yeah. So try to avoid. One more thing I would want to add here, Anusha, is Zoom does have background options, okay? But I do not recommend that. They don't look genuine because the screen keeps moving as and when you are moving on the screen, right? So I don't recommend that. So instead, have a background which is clean and plain so that it looks more neater and cleaner. Okay. Mm-hmm. Other one, other options, what I would, highly recommend is, I just want to go on one point which I missed, that was on the dress code, right?
Okay.
Whatever dress you're choosing or the attire you're choosing, you know, make sure it is neat, clean and ironed. No stains, nothing, you know, because that can give a bad impression. It looks as if you were not very careful or you were a little callous about it. So, and we don't want the interviewer to feel that. Okay, so that is another aspect I feel is extremely important. In a nutshell, what I would say is Zoom interview is no different than a face-to-face interview. Treat it as if, you know, you're meeting the person face-to-face. Right, because everything is going to be observed, everything is going to be noticed about you, how you're wearing, what you're wearing, how you're sitting, how you're talking, how you're moving, everything. Another aspect one needs to be very very particular about is your camera, you know, your camera, the way you're facing the camera. The camera should be at an eye level so that the interviewer feels you're looking at him. The eye contact needs to be maintained. The reason being is, one, you're able to build a relationship. Two, you're able to build a rapport. You're able to build a trust and respect, importantly. Because when you don't look at the eye and you look here and there and everywhere, but not at the interviewer, that's going to give a little bad impression, right? And when you're arranging your camera, make sure this part is clearly seen, not your ceiling or windows. Something which is not required to be seen, avoid that. Just this part, your face should clearly see, so that the interviewer is able to focus on you and not get distracted. And the other important aspect would be your light. Okay. If, for example, if you're sitting, if the window is, say, behind you, definitely that's going to cover your face with a shadow. So
yeah.
What will happen by this is the interviewer will not be able to see your face clearly. Instead, sit where there's enough light falling on your face so that your face has been seen clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And while you're doing that, when it comes to hair, a lot of people don't know what to do with hair, especially girls who have long hair.
Yeah.
You know, they have those bangs, those fringe that you call them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it keeps falling on their forehead, and they're half the time they're just doing this. Avoid
it's very
doing
distracting.
That. Instead, mm-hmm. Yes. Instead, pin them up behind. Okay. If you have long hair, like how you have amazing long hair, right? So what you would do is you would tie it behind. You won't even keep on your shoulder. The way, if someone does like this, I wouldn't recommend that, especially for the interview. You may want to keep it behind, your fringes all tied behind. If it's a short hair, then there's nothing to worry at all. Like, for example, my length, the way I've pinned it right now, nothing is falling on my face. And first of all, my hair is very unmanageable because of the texture I have. So all the more people who have texture like me in terms of hair, they need to be more careful how they want to do it. Right, that is another. For men especially, don't spike your hair. You're not going for a fashion show there. Okay, don't spike your hair. Have trimmed, neatly combed hair. Even if it is a beard, have trimmed beard. So that you get those specific cosmetics, you know, for taking care of your beard. You can even have those. Another important part would be, especially this is for girls, on your nail paints, right? Don't use flashy colors. I know even I love flashy colors, but not in the interview. You may want to go for some neutral shades like pinks or browns or transparent colors, which is not distracting. The idea here is, the reason why I'm saying this, we don't want the interviewer to get distracted by anything and just focus on your conversation. Because we don't want him to get, you know, distracted by what color you're wearing, or you know, or how is your hair. We just want to be focused on the skills that you bring on the table and how beautifully are you explaining that. And at the end, like I have mentioned one of my video, during the process there will always be an option given to you to ask and question. So don't lose that opportunity. Do not lose it. Go well prepared. What questions do you want to ask the interviewer? Definitely don't ask something where you have the answer for, but ask some intelligent, appropriate questions.
Mm-hmm.
For example, okay, could you please let me know, how do you see the challenges in this role? Something like this, you know. So by asking such questions, you are able to understand what is that you're getting into. At least it's giving an approximated, understanding that you can have about it. Right. So have those questions readily available in your mind so that you are asking the interviewer before you depart or exit from the interview. So once you clear your main exams of UPSC, what you need to, I'm going to give you a few tips. Well, there are a lot of, but I'm just going to talk few given the time constraint that we have. Number one, start early. What I mean by that is, don't wait for the results. Start working on your personality from day one. Number one. Number two, understand what are your strengths and weaknesses. I highly recommend everybody here to do their own SWOT analysis, because that's going to help you when you really get into the interview. So you understand what are your strengths, your weakness, your challenges, opportunities, right? So when you're getting into in the interview of UPSC, if you know your weakness well in advance, you'll have that much time to prepare for yourself before you get into the interview. You're able to counter all of that. That is two. Number three, be very positive. There are some things we cannot control. Nobody can do anything about it. So don't focus what you can't control. Focus on what you can control. And that's how you will be more positive. Don't think about the results. Think how you're going to give your best and work towards that. Then be calm. Extremely important. There's no point getting nervous.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, when you know everything, you don't have to get nervous. So you have to practice, you have to do a lot of mock interviews with your friends or family, professors, whoever you're comfortable with. Do the amount of practice, the more amount of practice and mock you do, the more confident you're going to be. Okay, and this applies for everyone here. Second, the UPSC board members who will take your interview, right? Mm-hmm. They expect you to be expert in your subject. So even after examinations, please go back to your textbooks and read everything. Because you never know what they're going to ask, and then you don't want to be in a situation where you are stuck, because they expect you to know everything, right? And that's why they're interviewing you for it. Then continuously read current affairs newspaper. Don't stop, because they are going to ask you the real-time questions. They're not going to ask something which is general and, you know, okay kind of question. They're going to really ask you, they're going to really drill your brains. So do that. Then other important thing would be, and this again applies to everybody, just be yourself. Don't try to fake. Because if you fake, you're calling for trouble. Just be yourself. Don't sound as if you have by-hearted some answers. Just get into the natural flow. You know, it's okay. Even if you don't get the right word at that moment, it is okay. But go with the natural flow. Then the other thing I just thought of was, look at your bio data n number of times, or your resume to that matter, right? Because you don't want any information when they ask you and you're not aware of. You cannot go wrong or fumble there when it comes to your personal questions. You need to be confident there, right? So visit your resume n number of times, making sure whatever information you've given, and this again applies to everybody, whatever information you've given is true and authentic, and you're able to establish the facts. So this is for you. I think it was Roy Official who had asked this question.
Yes.
So it is for you, Roy. I hope I have answered. If you need to know more, you can reach out to us.
Okay, we have two questions right now. One is asked by Kundan. He asks how to handle nervousness during an online interview.
Okay, so nervousness, Kundan, number one, you need to, the more you practice, you will not get nervous. So practice, practice, practice. That's a thumb rule, I would say. Second, even if you get nervous, do breathing techniques. You know, do deep breathing, inhale, exhale. Have a glass of water always next to you. So it might happen spur of a moment when the question has been asked. Quite normal that one of you can get nervous. So have a glass of water. Sip the water. That will help you calm down. One. Second, it will give you a few seconds to think what you want to respond back. So that's a trick you can do actually. And by breathing, what happens is when you are aware of your own breathing pattern, what happens is you are able to give more oxygen to your brain so that it is able to think more better, and you kind of come back in control and then respond. All right? But the thumb rule is practice, practice, practice.
Kundan, we have specifically made a video that is on the topic only, how to handle nervousness during your interview, on our YouTube channel. It is by Ashwini ma'am only. You can go, anyone who's interested to handle your nervousness can go ahead and watch it on our YouTube channel. It's Interview Cracker for You on YouTube. So if you have more questions, if you want more elaborate answer, you can go ahead and watch the video. And moving on to the next question, Archie Kamath has asked, what to tell the interviewer when we don't know the answer for the question asked?
Okay. So Archie, it is okay. For example, it is not necessary we will know everything, and it is perfectly okay if you don't know. So you can tell the interviewer saying that, I'm sorry, I'm not quite aware, but I will definitely go back and check on this, and revert. You can say something like this, but there's no point if you don't know. Don't try to fake it. Just say you're not aware at the moment, but you will definitely go back and do some research on it.
Okay. And if you want more such content, more answers to how to ace your interview, do watch our YouTube channel, Interview Cracker for You. We are there. If you have any questions, queries, DM us. We'll answer your queries. And we'll see you again next week.